Hi and welcome again. It's almost 1st of May, so officially the farming season. We had our friendly and valuable neighbor Petros come over yesterday and 2 days ago, and he moved the soil. It's not plowing per se, it's more just turning the soil over. So he has an amazing big machine, and it took him literally half an hour to do something that would take me 3 days if I tried to do it manually. So now the garden is ready for the new growing season. As you probably have seen in the previous video, I have a lot of cups full of stuff that need to go in the soil, especially tomatoes. They had significant growth since the last time I filmed. And they are quite big, they cannot wait any longer. So I counted them, and in total I have 158 tomato plants that are ready to plant, as well as 71 cucumber plants. So I do not have enough space for all of that, even though my inner gardener would love to get all of those things ready and going. So I'm gonna give some of the saplings, I guess. I'm gonna give those to Petros, the neighbor, and some other neighbors as well, probably. Which will still leave me with a lot of plants, so part of them will go in the main garden and part of them will go behind the house where I'm preparing boxes. Raised beds, that's the word. I prepared a raised bed and I do plan to have some more. So let's get into this. Had more or less a decent success in growing tomatoes. It was my first year growing tomatoes on such a big scale. Well, it's not a huge industrial scale, but it is still a big scale compared to a few pots on the balcony. However, what was the most tedious part was watering them. We do have remnants of the watering system hanged on a fence that you could probably see in some other videos. I am not sure how exactly it works and how to check which parts are broken, so I came up with an alternative budget and recycling watering system. So what I did was taking the bottles from water and I made some small holes in them. So the plan is that I will just dig those in the soil, plant tomatoes and other plants around them, and then I will just fill the bottles from top and they will slowly seep through directly to the roots. The problem is that the soil we have is clay, it's basically clay. So in the summer when it gets really hot, it turns into a rock. very hard. So here we are, trying to overcome the difficulty of having very hard soil that gets even harder and evaporates immediately after watering. So yeah, this year we are trying the bottles. I hope it will work. I'm starting with only a few of those, just to check how deep I gotta go. And if it even makes sense, I hope it does. And that's about right. Okay. Here we go, then I will put one tomato over here, one over here, and it should work, in theory. Here we are. There are tomatoes up there, down, down over here, over there, and over there. They are looking quite sad though. They need some water. So we will plant them and water whatever is left. So, oops. Let's start with the variety that is called Pera d'Abruzzo. One of Italian varieties, so I'm hoping for amazing results given that the climate is very similar to Italy here. So let's go with those guys first.
Where is it, Chapa? This one.
Alright, so now we got the holes, we got prepared general layout. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put a little bit of manure, the dried animal poop, and then put the tomatoes, cover them in soil, and they are good to go. They just need to be watered after that. And this is how the most precious gardening resource looks like. It's just dehydrated fiber, I'd say. That's animal poop. Very precious. I think that I will prepare a fail-safe as well. Other than having the water bottles, I will prepare like a little river, let's call it, to water them if the bottles prove to be ineffective. Alright, this concludes the planting of the first part of tomatoes. In the meantime, Mr. Fox, the cameraman, is making more rows for corn and more tomatoes and all the other stuff. So there is one more very important component into growing tomatoes, which is the support. You need to support the plant since by nature it wants to grow flat. It's a vine. So we will need to put some support sticks for them. However, that's not the job for today. They can stay for a day or two without the stick for now. Let's go get some more some more plants to stick in the ground. So I came back from the storage house armed with very important items, which are the plaques, the plaques, sticks, tablets. Anyway, this thing and the marker, because there is 100% chance I will forget which tomato is which. There is a cat behind me. So yeah, let's go with those. I got next batch of tomatoes. This is a Polish variety grown from the Polish seeds that my mother sent me, and they are called the Sunrise. In Polish it's spelled as Poranek. So we will see how those ones grow. I have absolutely no clue, I never saw them before. So they do have a beautiful flowers though, even though they are a bit wilted. I don't know, can you see the flowers? Yeah, you can see the yellow flowers. So they are more than ready to be planted. First I will just put them in the cups, more or less, to see how many I can squeeze in a row for them to still have a comfortable distance between each other. You don't want to put them too densely, because then you will get less fruits, because the bees will have harder time to get to the flower, because the leaves will be too dense. So, learning on my last year's fails, I will put them more apart than before. So that was 4 out of 150. Also, why am I not putting the plastic bottles anymore? This is because I greatly underestimated the amount of bottles I will need. Yeah, mathematics is not my strong side. Yeah, so we are going the classic way without the bottles. And the bottles will only be in the part of the garden that is the most dry, which is, well, over there. At this point we have two rows of the morning. Here is one morning, here is the second morning. What we have next over there are the pink tomatoes. I've never seen a pink tomato, so I am really, really curious as to how those little guys will turn out. What we have planned next is something very goth. Next I have the black tomatoes and then yellow ones. So those are the two next rows. I don't have much space left because I have only 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rows and two very long ones on the side. The other ones are gonna be for other stuff. So I am getting a bit anxious about space, which was to be predicted, but we will see how it turns out. So yet another variety that I got is something called bistecca. That's another Italian variety of tomato. It's supposed to grow kind of flat and very big. So we will see how it goes and how it does here. Let's go and get some more. I've planted another variety. That's actually parsley. But I've planted another variety in this very long row that goes all the way to the fence. The variety I've planted is called the raspberry tomato. It's another Polish variety which I got from my mom. However, the sun is going down, so I don't think I can plant the rest of the tomatoes I have. I still got few empty rows over here, as you can see. And I still have a lot more tomatoes to plant.